I'm Paul Eastwood, director of Man Boy and Haphazard. In my films, ordinary people are given extraordinary abilities. Using influences such as The Punisher and Spider-Man, Batman and the Hulk, I've pieced together new worlds. But in 2005, I was blessed with a meeting that would influence me more than anything ever before. Today, you are going to meet that influence. A hero not super in power, but perhaps in a different way. Today, I'm going to introduce you to Clive. Of course, you may not know him as Clive yourself. He is much better known by his superhero name, HydroHead. But by the end of this documentary, you will have met one of the defining characters of the decade.
Hello, is this thing on? Hello.
It's fine, really. Yeah. So, Clive, or HydroHead, how did your career in vigilantism begin?
Well, it all started a few years ago. I was in a bank downtown and I was standing there and I was thinking to myself, anyone could actually be a superhero. It's just nobody had ever been brave enough before. Suddenly, there was this noise and it just came from behind me. And I turned around and there were these robbers there with guns.
Sounds scary.
It was, but I never felt so alive. I knew then what to do. It was so clear to me. So I told them. I said, stop!
Wow.
Yeah. So they shot me in the foot.
Oh.
Yeah. That kind of sucked.
So, yeah. The costume. What's the story with that?
The costume, yes. Well, I'm actually quite proud of this, actually.
I have it here somewhere. Wait. Just hold that a second. That's part of it. Here's my cape. And my suit jacket. Here we go, look at this.
Wow, that's the actual suit you wore?
Yeah, this is the one.
Have you got another one?
No, I'm afraid I just had this.
Oh, aren't you afraid you might rip it?
Ah, well, the trick there is not to rip it.
Oh.
Okay, and also, I think you'd be interested seeing my gimp.
Whoa!
The first thing that you need to be a superhero is
superpowers.
No, I mean, you don't actually need powers.
You do, otherwise you wouldn't be a superhero, would you?
No. Super, in the term superhero, only refers to the actions that the character does. For example, I've saved 3 people, Paul. 3 people could have died without me.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. It's like those teenagers.
I shall save you! Get up of them, you animal!
So, was Clive into superheroes as a child?
Well, you know how boys are. I mean, they watch a couple of cartoons, they read a few comics, and suddenly they're running around in the garden wearing a towel cape and their mother's underwear.
So, was he helpful as a child? Did he like helping others?
Well, actually, no. It wasn't quite how I'd put it. I mean, he was lazy, completely unhelpful around the house.
So it developed when he got older?
Well, you could say that, yeah. In fact, it was probably when he saw his first superhero film, and that's what actually got him into it.
What film was that?
Supergirl.
What, the 1984 one by Artistry?
No, the 2001 by Playboy.
What is it like being married to a superhero?
Well, it's just like any other marriage, really, full of its ups and downs. Well, of course, there's a few extra concerns, like the long nights alone waiting for news about Clive, but he knew my worries, so he bought in my skinny Vinny.
Was he a good husband?
Definitely. He quit his lifelong dream for me. He wanted to keep on heroing, but I said, Clive, I don't like this heroing of yours, and so he quit for me, and we settled down.
So, was it difficult for you to give up your mantle?
I didn't mind it too much. I got to sleep in on Sundays, and I could focus more on the simpler things in life. I missed the frills a little bit, of course, but Maggie made up for that, didn't you, dear?
I did my bit.
So, what do you think it is that helped your marriage to work?
Well, of course, the superhero job always keeps things fresh.
That's one word for it.
I was a little obsessed.
He wanted to come to our wedding in his outfit.
So, what do you think?
That suit is rented.
Oh, relax, they won't know.
Just go and put them on properly.
Really? Fine.
It's not that unusual to see a superhero give up his identity for a woman. The woman's always there for the hero, either as a future relationship or even as a lifelong friend.
So you think Maggie might be the reason that he gave up his career as a superhero?
Yeah, that was possibly a very, very big factor.
So I hear that you have a comic book club that Clive is an active member in.
Yeah, he's like one of the longest like running members that we've ever had. He usually comes down for like big occasions and he does many of the speeches for us. He's a great guy.
The guys at the club were a great help. Always there to listen to the stories of my exploits and really helpful in the making of the costume.
Well, the poncho was my idea actually.
I even suggested that they could join in. They never took up on that idea.
After Clive got that, like, giant beating, the other guys were a bit scared about joining in.
Do you ever have plans to take up your old mantle? Will HydroHead return?
No, I think I'm past that time now. It's a separate time in my life. Maybe in a few years, I could return. For one last shot, you know, but I don't think I'll ever take that.
Well, there you have it. A genuine look into the life of the world's first real superhero. Clive's actions are now world famous, and there are many websites dedicated to him. Clive himself has kept a large viral presence from his YouTube account and blogs.
Heroes have souls! Right, you don't know me. You're not God. Who?
Although Clive's career as a hero may be over, his actions prove that even though man has not yet found the key to superpowers, either through mutation, science, or random incident, there will always be people willing to stand up against evil, to choose right over wrong, and to protect the innocent. And now that HydroHead is no more, there is a vacuum waiting to be filled by another pair of super spandex and durable underwear. And in the meantime, there's always comic books. Cause you're one of-